I believe that homosexuality is both nature and nurture. I think there's absolutely nothing wrong with being gay or trans. It's just that it's a harder life emotionally. It's harder to find one's purpose. So it's harder to feel more fulfilled in life, no matter how you look at it. I wouldn't wish it on anyone, but I still see nothing wrong with it. It's certainly nothing to chastise someone for. As we feminize men more and more, I think we're going to see more gay people and more trans people. When we teach boys that their sexual attractions to women are evil, sinful, wrong, bad, or some other word or phrase that essentially means the same thing, we're teaching them that male, straight sexuality is bad, then the only thing left for boys to rout the sexual feelings into, that they're not going to get chastised for, would be homosexuality, or they might end up feeling like they shouldn't be the sex that they are, and develop a gender dysphoria of sorts. At that point, if someone has the predisposition to be able to be gay or trans, it would come out. An automatic reflex. It's not any sort of conscious choice. Although I suppose it could be, but generally I don't think it would be. So in addition to the biological standards that exist, our instinctual standards, there are indeed a number of very unrealistic social standards put onto boys. Some of these standards are indeed toxic. Unfortunately, the subject often doesn't get talked about that way because so many of the people that are talking about it, whether this is the message they want to put out or not, they are essentially pushing the message that masculinity itself is toxic, and that male sexuality is toxic, and that's unfortunate. It's really, really not a good message. You're not going to accelerate anyone's rights by shitting on another group.